chatbots, or bots, are supposed to be helpful. Ideally, they can take input, either spoken or text, and conform it to how they can serve the user. Whether it's playing music or ordering off the internet, the idea is that a bot takes spoken or text data and determine what task to perform. Lex allows you to create bots that can serve multiple intentions. Typically, the intentions are related. So you might have a bot for your entertainment app that takes input and tries to determine if you want to listen to music or watch a movie. Or maybe you have a dinner app with a bot that needs to determine first if you're ordering a meal, drinks, or dessert. Based on which one you want to do, the bot needs to gather specific data, so it has different questions for each path or different intentions of the user. Once all the missing pieces are filled in, it can fulfill the request. Fulfilling the request means doing what it was designed to do once it's gathered all the data. That will vary depending on the design of the bot and the purpose of your app. Getting started in creating a Lex bot is very easy and simple. That's the good news. And there is no bad news. That's it. When you're ready to create a bot, about the only thing you really need is a name for your bot. That's just about it, at least to create it and get started. You can pick some of the sample apps to base your bot off of, and that's a great way to learn and explore to see how other things are done. But we're going to start from scratch, and starting from scratch is a great way to get a clean slate and start your bot laboratory work. So let's create one now. So in Chrome, I'm going to go to the console at console.aws.amazon.com, and I'm going to search for Lex. I'll click on Amazon Lex, and we should see that we don't have any bots defined. And we don't, so we see this Getting Started page where we have all this information on LexBots. So we'll click Get Started. Now we can base our bot off of these samples of book trip, order flowers, and schedule appointment, and they kind of show you how they work a little bit. But we're going to do a custom bot based on nothing else, and we see the settings that we can specify. So we're going to use a bot name of Order Meal. And we use that name because this is the overarching idea of our bot. We're going to be ordering a meal, so that could be food, drinks, dessert, whatever we might include. If you just made it order food, that might be misleading that you can't order drinks or something. But our bot will be able to cover whatever we need. You can pick an output voice, like Kimberly.
Hello, my name is Kimberly.
You can put in some sample text here just to test the voice and press play.
Test the voice.
For the session timeout, this is how long your bot will wait for interaction from the user before it gives up. And we'll just do something like 2 minutes. We'll allow it to automatically create our IAM role, and we're going to specify that our bot is not specifically made for COPA. And then we'll create our bot, and that's all we have to do. Now our bot is at least created. It doesn't have anything and it doesn't do anything, but it's at least created. We see over here on the left that with the editor tab selected, we can see our intents, which we don't have any, and any slot types we've defined, which we haven't. We also see a section for error handling. Under the Settings tab, we see the general settings that we specified when we created the app. We also see aliases, which we'll look at later, but it allows you to point to different versions of your bot. For channels, we see an area where we can define the necessary configuration for different channels like Facebook, Kick, Slack, and Twilio. And then under monitoring, we see various tables that we can monitor the metrics for, and we can go to CloudWatch to see more details. There's also a place for utterances, which we haven't defined any yet, but we'll get to that. But the great thing is that's all we needed to start the creation of our bot, is basically specifying the name and a couple other little settings. Not much to it, and we're off and running. Earlier, I mentioned that our lovable bot creations have a purpose, or purposes. These purposes need to be defined as intents. Not intents, but intent items. So you have to ask yourself, what is the purpose? Or in other words, what's the, wait for it, intent? You can import previously exported intents, or use some of the existing intents you've defined before, or use some of the intents that Amazon provides. We haven't exported any, and the Amazon ones aren't really right for us. We'll look at those in a minute. So we're going to create our own. So I'm going to go to Amazon Services and type in Lex. If you aren't there, bring up the Lex console. And you'll see that now we do have a bot defined called Order Meal. Over on the left side, if we had any intents defined, we could look at those or slot types. but we're going to drill down into our order meal. Again, we have the editor tab selected, and we see we have no intents and no slot types. We can click on error handling and see the phrase that's repeated when the bot doesn't understand something. Let's say you go into the order meal bot and you ask to get an oil change. It can say, sorry, can you please repeat that 5 times? And then it'll hang up by saying, sorry, I could not understand. Goodbye. You can change those phrases if you want. So we're going to create an intent for our bot by clicking this plus sign next to the intents. And we can create the intent, import an intent, or search existing intents. We don't have any defined, so it goes only to the built-in intents from Amazon for cancel, help, loop, and so on. This isn't what we're looking for, so we'll create our own intent by clicking on Create Intent and giving it a name. Our name will be Order Food. So under our Order Meal bot, we're going to order food, and we'll click Add. Now we can click on our intent, Order Food, and see the definition of it. There's really not much there. Notice that, though, we have a whole process defined for us. We have all these processes and pieces of our bot that we need to configure so that it's able to get the information it needs to fulfill its purpose. The first thing your bot needs to know about this intent is when to kick it off. How does it know to use this intent? How does it know that the user needs this intent to fulfill their purpose? That's defined as part of the intent itself. If you were using this bot in an app, you might want to say something like, I want to order dinner. And then the bot knows to use this intent. It does that through what are called utterances of the intent. You can have multiple utterances for a given intent, and it's best to vary them a little bit. Mix it up. Lex will reconcile variations. So you might have utterances like, I want to order dinner, and I need food. Lex will reconcile that I need dinner works too. So let's create some utterly utterable utterances. So for this order food utterance, I want to say something like, I need food. I'm not going to put end punctuation because sometimes it needs to match that too. So I'll just leave it as that. It's also not case sensitive. So we could do feed me, where's dinner? I'll leave off the question mark also. And I want to order dinner. So the variations of this should be reconciled by the bot to know that I want dinner or I need dinner or I want to feed me an order of dinner might work. The bot will figure all that out for you. That's the great thing, is it's doing all the really hard work. So now, any of these utterances, whether they're typed or spoken, will kick off this intent. We can also add another intent that's very similar to this for something else like drinks or dessert. We'll have one that's order dessert. We'll add that. And then we're going to have some utterances for that one as well, like I want dessert. I have a sweet tooth. What's for dessert? That should do. And so now utterances like this should kick off this other intent. So when you've engaged this bot, depending on what phrases are typed in or spoken, will kick off either order dessert or order food. So now that we've defined a little bit in our bot, it would be great to be able to test it just to make sure that our utterances are well defined and everything's going along smoothly. So it would be great to be able to test it right here. And we can. But the first thing we have to do is build our bot. So we just tap build and tap build again there. Now this will build, and once it's ready, it'll tell us when it's done, and then we can test it. We'll be able to type in whatever utterances that we want to test for variations, and we could also test it audibly with the microphone. All we have to do is come over here and open this test chatbot area. We can type our utterances in here or tap the microphone to test it audibly. Now that it's done building, let's test it with something simple like feed me. Notice it says the intent order food is ready for fulfillment. That means it kicked off the right intent, order food, but since there's really nothing for it to do, it skipped right to fulfillment at the bottom and just says it's ready. Down below, we can see the responses and any details from our interaction. Right now, we're just looking at the summary, so there's not much to see. If we look at the detail, we can see the JSON that the intent name order food is ready for fulfillment. That's its state. There's nothing else really defined in here because we haven't done very much. Now, if we said, I want dessert. Notice that it kicks off the intent order dessert and it's ready for fulfillment. Let's try some variations of our utterances. Feed me dinner. Order food. I want something sweet. I need sugar. Order food. It picked up on the need, but the sugar didn't help. I need something sweet. Order food as well. Let's see what other variations we have in here. What's for dinner? It went for dessert. So we have some work to do to make sure that our utterances match what we really want. We need to specify some more things in food, maybe like, what's for dinner? And in dessert, maybe add some things like sugar or sweets or some other words to make sure that our utterances are just right to pick up everything that the user might type in. So let's add a few more utterances to see if we can get this a little bit smoother. What's for dinner should have started order food, but it started order dessert. So let's go to order food and add what's for dinner. I need something sweet, started order food, so let's go to dessert and add that in. I need something sweet. Now there's a lot more we could add in there, but once we build and test this, if we come up with anything else, we can always add those later to our utterances, build and test again. Now that it's built, let's try those out. I need something sweet, dessert. I want something sweet. I want sweet. Even that worked. What's for dinner? Order food. So now we've got it working a little bit smoother, and we can continue to refine that as necessary. We can clear the chat by clicking Clear Chat History, and we can also test audibly by clicking the microphone and saying things like, what's for dessert? Click it again to stop. It'll analyze the audio input, what's for dessert, and it starts the intent order dessert. That's exactly right. Let's try something a little bit harder. I'm ready for dinner. And it picked it up and did order food. Let's make sure it won't just do anything. What time is it?
Sorry, can you please repeat that?
Notice it doesn't recognize just anything, and if we continue to input items that aren't recognized, the error handling would kick in and it would hang up eventually.